Oh my goodness. Well, boxes from Hasbro Pulse have been arriving daily.
It's as wacky action.
Yeah, wacky action, Shredder.
This might also happen in the G.I. Joe world with people really liking the villains.
The Bandar prototype figure, the Bandar hard copy, and the Bandar 2-up.
But the hat and the tie and the jacket, that's...
It's a female Mythic Legions figure.
This was only released and sold in Argentina by the Top Toys company.
These are really, really hard to find. This is another beauty.
Wow.
When you love toys, you love them all.
I'm holding Anti-Eternia,
which is my favorite. Some Mexican beauty I see. Guerra de las Galaxias.
This one here is a Lady Darth Vader tie.
I've waited for this figure for a very long time, and I can say this time they really nail it.
There's nothing crazy special about it. All of it's special to me. This is something cool that CES.
Something not so special.
Exactly.
Meccano, for crying out loud.
1986 from Hasbro, and I've been looking for this gem in package for like 10 years.
My biggest collection is about robots. I have this one here.
Wow.
Yes, it couldn't be exactly what Action Force was in the 80s, but this is almost a reboot and a way to kind of bring Action Force back.
We made a deal for a pile. I cherry-picked it, you know, and so I got it in the mail. For 2 days, I'm like tinkering with my other, you know, collector buddies of Ghostbusters. Like, hey, what could this be? One episode, you know, because the date on it was 1 week prior to the first episode ever airing. I think I actually joked with someone, thinking, hey, what if it's the pilot, you know?
Like, her house at the time was just wall-to-wall G.I. Joe. It consumed the entire house, and that was part of the reason I think she got burnt out on collecting, is it was just a tidal wave of G.I. Joe.